Welcome back to another video of Letted Customs, guys. Today we're actually gonna go and pick up or collect a very rare rum. And most probably by the title of this video, guys, we're gonna know what it is. I almost swapped my vehicles for the specific rum, but luckily I made the guy offer. It's an offer he accepted as well. So I really hope the owner of the spoons at the moment finds a Vitek wheel, but I'm just happy I can buy this wheel. I'm actually gonna leave my house at the moment, or my grandmother's house, and we're gonna drive to Mitchell's Plain, which my girlfriend is not very fond about for some reason. No offense, Mitchell's Plain owners, or yeah, Mitchell's Plain residents. We'll be heading to Mitchell's Plain and we will be collecting this specific wheel. Like I said, most probably by the title of this video, guys, you know what it is, but just wait and see until the wheel is on the car before you comment anything down below. Well, guys, we're almost home. I just filled up the tank because apparently it's raining tomorrow, so unfortunately I can't fill up tomorrow. You guys know I don't drive the car in the rain. Got the spoons, here's the pack. Got that Pick n Pay Express chips though, like always. Unfortunately Shannon can't have any because he's I think you already passed your 2 cheat days for the month. It's a must for you, girl, and the month just started. So I'm just gonna head home and then I'm gonna take like a small break, and then after that we can actually start fitting the spoons on the car. Yeah, guys, let's hit you guys up with a nice cinematics. Like to mention to you guys, please have to excuse like the background. Me and a friend across the road, he actually helped me, like that's all rubbish there on the shelf. So like that bags like this, like recycling bags, and obviously the black bags are trash. So then we have those pallets and stuff like that, and that mattress kind of vibe. So I still need to clean out everything right here. This section here I'm gonna build over completely. So like I said, I'm gonna like design this place like into like my new workshop kind of vibe. Here we have like a storage place right here, so I need to put like a door and a light in here. And I know you guys have been complaining about like lighting, and the lighting is very bad. Like I only have like this light right here, and obviously that one right there, and obviously I have like one there in front as well, so it's quite bad. But I'm definitely gonna make this garage way better. And my friend Jason actually said he has someone who can like hook me up like with painting the logo on the wall, so I'll definitely invest in that. But at the moment I just want like the entire section right there closed up. So I'm gonna put like a roof on there. This roof right here is like completely like messed up, so I want to like cover that entire roof right there. There's an opening there by that window right there that has to be closed as well. And obviously this section right there, which you guys see on top, I'm gonna try to put a light on each corner, at least two LED lights here on top as well as there, so then we can actually have some nice lighting here. And I want to invest some actually money in some tools as well, so that we have like some proper equipment, and then we don't have to like loan like tools or like, if you know what I mean. But I definitely need a 3-ton jack, so if you guys maybe have a second hand 3-ton jack, because at the moment I don't think I want to invest in a 3-ton jack that's like brand new, because it is quite expensive. So I might just invest in a second hand one. But enough about that. I just wanted you guys to know why it looks like this in the background. But let's get to putting the spoons on the car. This is the spoons I actually bought. So it is actually amazing. Khaled really has the Rigamaster stickers on, the Evo sticker as well, so I don't need to like reprint stickers for the wheel. At the back I will be running with the 215-45-16, and obviously in front I'll be rolling with the 205-45-16. And the color of the wheels are simply amazing, which I think would really look amazing on the car. So I'm just gonna put you guys on a stand real quick, then we can get the wheels on the car. I'm gonna roll with the 205s in front and with the 215s at the back. Guys can actually see how meaty the tire looks. Obviously I don't usually like run these wide tires on my car. It's the first time I will be rolling with 215s on my rear end. I actually rolled with 205s, which was Jody's Vox, but this will be a first. I just adjusted the camber in front because for some reason the camber this side was more negative than that side. Well, positive camber, it's outwards, negative camber is inwards. Correct me if I'm wrong. But adjusted the camber, we're gonna put the spoons on real quick. Oh shit, I almost hit the wheel full. I just need you guys a comparison between like this wheel, which is the 1-in-5 tire, in the 15, and obviously the 16 right here. Not much of a difference, but I mean like a slight bitchy difference. This is a 45 profile, this is a 50 profile, but this is a 1-in-5 in width, and that's a 205 in width. But that one at the back, yo, that one is not as a bitchy wide. And it has a bit more profile to it for some reason. Like how they calculate a specific tire's profile, it's very weird. I literally don't understand it that well. But all I know is that thing's profile is also 45, but it's thicker in the front and the width is wider as well. Well guys, I hope you guys will be able to like see how the wheel looks on the car. Unfortunately the lighting is quite bad, and I am gonna sort out the lighting like I promised. So I'm definitely gonna like try to put like a light in each corner, especially like this side right here. So one there, one there, one there, and obviously one here in front as well. And hopefully I can sort that out. But thus far, the car looks amazing to me. Personally for me, the VTEC wheels obviously take the cake for me. But I think I must leave the wheel on the car, let it sink in, because it usually takes some time before the wheel actually sinks in. I knew the 16-inch wheel or 16-inch spoon won't look that dope on the car, but the reason is Or the reason being is it's not the look I want to go for the car. Like the rim is what I want to go for the car, but not like the bumpers and the rear bumper and side skirts and everything like that. So obviously I have something I have up my sleeve, but you guys will have to wait and see. And no, I'm not going new spec. So obviously I would like some separate bumpers and stuff like that, then I can actually like get like, well, the car a different look. So when I put on the OEM wheels, I just put OEM bumpers on and then I have that look. But if I put the spoons on, I can change the bumpers, I can change, well, a few other stuff, and then I have a different look on the car. But this far, well, I'm extremely happy with the wheels. I guess I would sell the wheels if I got a good offer. I don't know. I really have been looking for 16-inch spoons for quite some time, and I'm not sure if you guys know this or not, but you don't get 16-inch spoons here in South Africa. Like, you literally don't get it at all. The only way to get it is to import it, like from obviously like other country. I'm not sure like how specifically that works, but all I know is that you can't go to a store here in South Africa and go buy these wheels. You have to import it from, I'm not sure if it's what, from what country specifically, but all I know, you don't get it in South Africa. So that is why it makes these wheels so rare and why it makes it so special on this car. I hope you guys liked today's video. I mean, like, this is definitely a very rare find. And if you guys do come across a 16-inch spoon or 16-inch valve, definitely grab it. People do like sell these wheels for quite some money. I actually paid some money for these wheels as well, obviously, but I think I might just keep the wheels on the car for a little while. I know you guys actually voted for the VTEC wheels to be fitted on the car, and I actually fitted the VTEC wheels on the car and it looked amazing, and I went for the beach drive. But now I got my hands on a set of 16-inch spoons and it's definitely worth the buck. So what do you guys think? Do you guys think I should keep it this specific color? Do you guys think I should respray it a different color? Comment down below. I actually like the color, I actually like the stickers on it, but comment down below, because I wouldn't say I do everything you guys say, but I'll go according to the vote. But guys, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Like I said, everything is getting even more excited on this channel. That car definitely right here is going for spray soon. This BM right here is definitely coming back with a bang. Looking for a six speed Beams gearbox for that car. And then obviously this car is gonna have some accessories done to it as well, like a few stuff here and there. And obviously my Golf right there must go in for spray. So the channel is gonna, well, grow, I guess, and we're gonna have some exciting stuff for you guys. So definitely subscribe if you guys want to stay tuned what will be going down with the yellow thing as well as the VTEC. So guys, like, subscribe, comment down below, and remember, stop racing and go Stones.